Hi, I'm Hans and I work here at Bekaert as responsible for the concrete lab and new product development. And in this video I will be talking about creeping concrete. Creep is a tendency of a solid material to deform slowly over time under the influence of a constant load. We have all witnessed creep at some point when looking at, for instance, a bookshelf filled with textbooks. The fact that these shelves tend to sag over time is in fact creep. Creep is not limited to bookshelves though. On the contrary, any material will creep, even steel will creep when exposed at very high temperatures. Concrete behaves differently because it will creep at any given temperature and at any stress level. When a load is placed on a concrete structure, it will immediately show an elastic deformation. When this load is sustained over time, the deformation will grow. This is what we call creep. This will happen quickly at first, and then gradually it will be slowing down. When the load is removed again, the concrete will spring back to some extent, and also some of the creep deformation will continue to return. This is what we call creep recovery. And part of the deformation is, however, irreversible. You can also look at creep from another point of view. When a loaded specimen is restrained so that it cannot deform, then the stress level in the specimen will gradually decrease. This is what we call relaxation. This effect shows that creep can be positive as well as negative. It can be undesirable when a structural reinforced beam is deflecting over time, but in a statically indeterminate structure like a slab on ground, the relaxation effect will relieve stress concentrations. There are many factors that can influence the creep of concrete, and I will highlight two of them in this video. In terms of the composition of the concrete mix, the cement paste is where all the creep occurs. The aggregates in the mixture, they will not creep, but when you use a stiffer aggregate, the resulting concrete will be more resistant to creep. Another important factor of influence is the amount of water in the cement paste. Concrete with a lower water to cement ratio, or a stronger concrete, will show less creep. And in addition, because concrete becomes stronger over time, it will creep less when you wait longer to put a load on it. How does all of this relate to fiber-reinforced concrete? Well, despite being around for more than half a century, nearly all research on fiber-reinforced concrete has been focusing on the properties of the fresh state or on short-term mechanical properties. It's only very recently that long-term behaviors such as creep came to the attention of researchers. Most applications of fiber-reinforced concrete are in statically indeterminate structures, which benefit from the relaxation effect. However, as creep can also increase crack openings and deflections over time, Model Code 2010 has acknowledged that creep should be taken into account when designing structural applications, but it doesn't offer any design guidelines or test standards. And the RILEM committee was established in 2014 to address this lack of guidelines. And together with the industry and university labs from all around the globe, Bekaert is involved in this committee, and we hope to publish our findings by the end of this year. One thing has become clear in the study so far. There's a strong relation between the fiber material and the creep behavior of the fiber-reinforced concrete. If the material of the fibers is prone to creep, then so will the resulting fiber-reinforced concrete be. If you are designing an application where you absolutely do not want any creep at all, then you're better off using steel fibers because they will greatly reduce the effects of creep. If you have any questions related to this topic, please let them know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.